Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today, we're gonna deal with a Selenium web driver issue with using Chrome. Today is July 23rd, 2023. This error came up about 3 to 4 days ago, I think. Let me show you the error, but first, feel free to hit me up on my socials here. The highlighted portion is the error message that you're going to get due to the latest update of Google Chrome, 115. This is the error that you're going to get. We need to figure out a stable version that's going to work, and two examples I have for you to get you going. I will also give you some background of what's the problem and how to think about this. I'm not going over the code today. If you want to get any of the code to work the prior example from the previous video of Indeed web scraping, go for it. The link will be above. I'm letting you know I'm using the newer version of Selenium, which is 4.10. If you notice, this is the problematic piece of code that we have. This is the portion of code that's giving us the hiccup. It's getting the binaries for our drivers used in conjunction to Google Chrome. The reason we're having this issue is that the driver isn't up to date with Chrome, the newer version of Chrome. We have two ways of getting around this today. This portion right here is what's the biggest hiccup that we need to deal with. You can remove this, run this piece of code, and it'll start running. We have another option. What's really going on behind the scenes is what is important. If we have an installation of 15 on our computer, but the driver isn't compatible, you need to have the option to downgrade internally through the web driver of Selenium to use a previous version. If we didn't understand and we were trying to find this from scratch, what are some of the workarounds that we would need to do to start investigating to get an idea or have a first clue? On the upper right hand portion of this panel, you see the three vertical dots. You would hit those, you go to help, you go to about Chrome, click that, you would figure out what version you have. I have the updated version. A few days ago when this happened to me, I had 114, but 115 was an update that's internal through Google Chrome that does automatic updates, which is an irritation. There's ways to work around that to delete a bunch of files so this doesn't happen in the future. And yes, I have a super old version of Mac OS. I'm just lazy and haven't updated. That's the first line of defense. If you had to relaunch this to get a newer version, normally this is what you would do to resolve your issues. The next issue you would try to resolve is looking at the actual drivers that we need to investigate. So if we zoom in here, this is where you would go and download the drivers if you're doing this manually. But Selenium as of 4.6 internally finds the drivers that we need, so we do not explicitly need to call these or store these somewhere and attach the file path. The only thing you need to worry about is having the actual installation of the browser, such as Chrome, Edge, or Firefox, for example. As long as you have those, any of the dependencies can be found internally within Selenium. If you pay attention here, this is the last version that I had that was stable and you could get this driver. But if you pay attention, anything Chrome 15 or newer right here requires you to do this testing, whatever this is, all this junk. So just click that. And it says, here's a stable version that you can download. And I'm not sure if you have to attach the path or if this is even relevant yet. If I'm correct, I had issues with this on Friday. This is Sunday. I don't know if this will be resolved soon, but we have one more workaround that does work right now. When I went to Stack Overflow, I saw that when I looked Thursday or Friday, I didn't see any of these issues popping up. And then now I'm just seeing a bunch of people throwing this, and that's why I'm making this video. If we went to Stack Overflow, you would see that people are having the same issue, and this is 4 days ago. There's other postings that are from 2 days ago, and etc. And like I said before, this is the line of code that gives us that issue with this particular driver. It's just incompatible at the moment. I don't know if it's going to be resolved or if later you have to do further workarounds with third-party software, such as this right here from GitHub called Selenium Base. I have not used this. I cannot at this time say it works because I don't know. At your own leisure, read up on this and see if this is a workaround. Supposedly, it could work with this specific driver. but I wanted to throw it out there. One option you have is disabling automatic updates for Chrome. Really what I think is the most important is getting the general background of what's going on with the web driver for Selenium, so you could try to help yourself out later on before you start updating your OS, updating everything from Chrome, seeing that nothing works, start deleting things, such as deleting the Chrome browser, reinstalling. Try to avoid doing all that unless you absolutely need to. The other option is an explicit call using the web driver of a known stable version. This was my last stable version. I do know this works. We can run this piece of code and see that it works as well. It takes a second to load, go through all the rigmarole, and there you go. This is the second workaround. There's another way you can do this. It's a little bit slower. If you need to find out where your drivers are installed on your computer, you can run this command in Jupyter Notebook or just throw this in the terminal and it'll show you where it's located, and then you have to go into the folders and you can find all your drivers and work from there if that's something you needed to do for some reason. Running this as well, this will still give an error on my machine because of this. I tried to remove that Chrome services, but I still get this error. The only two options I have are either using this with the stable version, throwing it into it, or doing the first example where we would use this instead with nothing in there for the install. Let that work for a second behind the scenes, which also works. So you can use this or the same exact thing here and put in place there a known working version. So some of the background. As of Selenium 4.6, I said this before, you're starting up a workspace where you do not need to worry about anything being a requirement and everything's done for you right out of the box. All you need to do is have the browser installed prior to working with any of this, because the problem that you would always have is updating drivers, making sure that they're compatible with your browser, which is an issue because there's always updates for security preferences and things like this every few weeks, it seems like. Don't necessarily think you have to downgrade your version of Chrome. You could just do it internally through Selenium. You don't have to mess about with your actual machine. I tried to run these lines of code to see where these files were in my machine, but it didn't work. I don't know where it's installed or how it's working because I'm working in Jupyter Notebook maybe. I don't know. The last way that I was thinking you can do this would be just setting up the webdriver.chrome and then calling the service directly like we did in the previous version without calling the install. And this is kind of set up like the same as before, I think. But that's how you can get your workaround. Lastly, before we depart, here's something I saw on Stack Overflow. You could stop this and read it real quick. This is a suggestion that someone was thinking about to go through and try to fix this on your device. It appears that they probably have a Windows machine. Is this workaround useful or not? Don't know, but I'm just throwing it out there as another supplemental piece of information. This video will not be on my GitHub unless I'm asked specifically for it, but here are the citations that I have. Feel free to hit me up again on my socials. Please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. And if you would like to consider supporting the channel, it would be greatly appreciated through Super Thanks, channel memberships, or buy me a coffee. I have Patreon. I'm not on it often, but feel free to hit me up. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video. Bye.